You're watching Alex Yu Show. I'm Alex, delivering 300 seconds of life-changing wisdom. So today we have Laura, and we are in Medellin, Colombia. And we are at the, I would say, one of the healthiest restaurants in Medellin. And Laura here is the owner and founder of the restaurant. Laura, hi, how are you?
All right.
Perfect. So tell us a bit about your restaurant. Why did you open it? What inspired you?
Well, disappointment with several things. First of all, I came from the academic world and I didn't want to stay longer, you know, teaching students and correcting essays.
You were a teacher?
Yeah,
okay.
I was a PhD student, so I didn't want to continue with that life.
Okay.
And I say, very disappointed with, you know, that career. I'm going to set up a restaurant.
Just like that?
Yeah, just like that. And everyone said like, yeah, great idea, just do it. Okay, I'm going to try.
But why a healthy restaurant?
Just because this is the way I eat.
That's how you eat. That's
this
you practice
eat.
That.
Yes. This is how I eat.
Wow.
Basically. I think, and then for me, healthy is when you cook in your home, like your grandma would. If you're going to make tomato soup, you just grab lots of tomatoes, put them with thyme, you know, spices, onion, and stuff like that. So we don't use any industrial preservatives or anything like that. We try to get our food organic as much as possible.
Okay.
And just do it as your grandma would do. I mean, just proper food.
Real food.
Real food.
Yes. Does it actually matter if it's healthy food or it's just a trend? Or it's just a lot of noise? Is it actually important?
I think it does.
Yeah.
I think it does. And I think the most important thing about healthy food is to get it as natural as possible. One. Two, well balanced. Just eat a little bit of everything. Just don't overdo on, you know, just fat or just carbs or just no fat at all.
It's a balance. So one of your wisdoms is balance.
I would say it's balance.
So don't go extreme. So on a daily basis, people want to know often, what is it you actually do practically to stay healthy that you do? A few things maybe you can do. Yes.
Just eat as much food as I need, as I feel my body needs. Not
okay.
Less, not more, in terms of quantity.
Okay.
You know, if you're hungry, eat something that nurtures.
Nurtures you, that gives you. So you follow your body's instincts, whatever your body
wants. Yeah. And then sometimes it happens, like, I don't like very much meat, but there is one day in the month that I think like, I want chocolate. And then I realize that, yes, I go to my period. But I wasn't aware of that. And my body knew it.
Yes.
In a way, I think the body is very wise. So I think we forget to listen to our bodies, to read the that the body gives. Healthy is what's healthy for you. Broccoli is really a fantastic food to eat. But if it happens that it makes you bloated and it doesn't make you well, then broccoli is not good for you. Don't eat broccoli. Although the world says broccoli is nasty.
I agree with you. Maybe a couple of closing questions. Your business is very successful. I can say that. The reviews say that. How do you balance? Because, you know, having a career and success in a business and personal life, how do you balance that?
And I touch upon what to delegate.
Delegation.
Yeah.
That's an important word, guys. Delegation. So empowering people. Delegated that. Right?
So I have a fantastic team.
I see that. How many? There's a few people here.
Oh, no, it's like 10.
10 people. And they're all awesome. So you're empowering people. You're not afraid to give them the task. Right? Because you can't do it all yourself.
Definitely not.
No, not to that great extent.
Yeah, I know.
Okay, final life wisdom that you can give us. Anything that has been good for you in life that has kept you going? Closing.
I know, probably just keep going with things. You know, just keep the wheel of life moving, even if you sometimes don't want to. Just keep doing what you have to do. And then you find a sense and meaning after you do it. Sometimes you don't find it. I mean, you don't have to think a lot. Shall I do this? Shall I do that? No, you just keep going with your life and you go to yoga class and you go to your work and you go to do what you want to do.
I hope you caught that, guys. It's not about staying in your thoughts all day long. It's about actually doing things in life, even though you don't know what will actually happen or it seems difficult. You go with it. And I had a great interview with Laura. It was a pleasure meeting you, Laura. Thank you very much. I'll post some pictures of this beautiful cafe and the food that they serve. This was Alex introducing 300 seconds of life-changing wisdom. Bye.